And welcome back. And get outside here. This is sort of working. I made a couple of changes. I took out the... I don't know why I was thinking... I know why I thought I needed to, but I didn't. So I took that one out. So the weird part is, yeah, technically the hatchlings can get under here and over here, and then apparently they can grow up, and because it's a half slab, they don't get killed by getting too tall, which is good overall. I mean, it's not bad, it doesn't hurt anything. Either way, I wasn't going to likely get the meat from them. Eh, I also added some stairs, although maybe not very well. I think I actually have 30-something chickens in here now. Wait, 78? 79? No, 42. I looked at the wrong number. So that's a lot of chickens. I don't know if it's including any of these. It might still be in my scope of vision. Yeah, so... I guess the good news is... Well... Moderately good. I'll do this in a sec to show you, but... If I, you know, activate the piston, the adults right here are dead. That one will probably survive because he's over there. Some of the hatchlings will get pushed over there and then possibly just stand there till they grow up, I don't know. And others, if they're actually down in the hopper, they don't get pushed up and out, they just get pushed, and it's the same as just being crushed. So here's how that works. So, yeah, if one of them drops down into that, and it looks like one's probably about to, maybe not. Well, the point is, it just kills hatchling. And then, yeah, these, if they grow up, are just going to wind up stuck. They're laying eggs here, and about that, I am getting eggs. And it's got me thinking... You know, I went off and found a couple of chickens to kill. It got me thinking, I really could kind of cycle all this, I guess. Oh, why am I up here? If I'm going to do that, I'm going to need some things I don't have. Although I could probably get them. I don't know if I have it here. What I need is more of these dispensers. Which is rocks, which I have lots of, and string, which I have 5 of. And I've got lots back at the island, but that doesn't mean anything while I'm here. So, yeah, that's a bit of an issue. otherwise, I'm not sure what I think of, the whole system where it's going under and then, but not. Because they should, I would think, maybe if there were more of them, although I just killed a bunch, so it probably doesn't help. If there were more of them, they might get pushed, and then once they're here, they'd realize they could hop up and go wherever, but... I don't think it's working. So yeah, what I'm thinking is if I have a... I guess what I want to do is go under here. You know, that one. Which I might even be able to do. Do I have a... No. Put a hopper right there going this way. you know, possibly directly. I could use a lot of dispensers to make this happen, and that's going to be a lot of redstone also to keep them going. Or, you know, the simple version, I just pull out eggs and throw them back into the system whenever it gets full. I guess that's a way to do it. I don't know. I kind of think if I... That's not a golem, right? That's a tree. Alright. If I do anything to it, I'll probably not bother recording it, and I'll just go over what I did, having done it, if I do it, if that makes any sense. Yeah, so that's just... It's not working. I mean, it's kind of... Yeah. It's sort of better than nothing, I guess. And it's kind of neat, I guess. I would probably be happier with it if I hadn't done what I did. And just had a block right here, but the fact is, if I try to put a block right there, it's not going to work. They're all going to escape. But pushing them under isn't working. Not really. How did you die? Maybe they do get crushed. Well, that's what I was hoping for in the first place. Huh. Okay. I don't know. Yeah, I guess it's the same as a piston, just only being able to push like 12 or 13, whatever it's able to do. It may be something like that, where this many entities can't all be pushed, at the end it'll form a wall that crushes all the others. It's a mess, I'll fix it, I'm not going to do it on camera. We know it doesn't work, I can start from that and get it maybe working some other way. So that leaves what I want to do today, which I don't know. I was wandering around, I killed a couple of chickens I found over there. And while I was doing that, I looked up, and it's not the case now, but from over here, I saw a, llama, which I guess kind of makes sense, because those would live over here. Now here's the problem, I don't know offhand what to do with llamas. I know you can get a lead on one and all the neighboring llamas will follow it. I don't have a lead, and I don't know if I have any kind of food that they would chase. But there they are. So, they probably don't like seeds. Do they like wheat? Not terribly. How about... that's what I have. Well, nuts. I don't know what they eat. I haven't played with llamas much. Kinda. When we first got them, I found some, and it was actually on this map. It was way closer to home. There's that village, which is no longer all that exciting, because I've got lots of villagers. So what I may want to do... And this is granting it's going to take time even just to get there. Is go home. If I can find a way down this mountain. And then I'm not sure of. And at the minimum. get some slime. Things. Cubes. Whatever the hell they are. Ultimately I need slime balls to make a lead, unless I find one somewhere, but suddenly I'm wondering about that. Have I ever found one? It seems like they can be found in crates occasionally somewhere. I don't know. I don't remember finding one and setting it anywhere. I think I would have used it by now for something. So instead, what else have I got? I've got this junk I don't need. Chop down some overhangs on roofs to get these stairs, which now I'm done needing stairs for anything. That's a thought. I could probably, because I have three right here. I was going to take those home sometime. I could probably, do a daylight sensor that would basically, if the sun is out, this would be in crushing position. And of course, if it's in crushing position, it looks like this, which means they just land on, and then at night it opens up, and any chickens hanging out up there waiting to, go where they belong. A day being 10 minutes, and a night being 10 minutes minus however long I'm asleep. That could work. Actually, this is irrelevant. If I'm going home, I'm not in danger of anything. Sure, I'm ready to go, whatever, I don't care. Just run through the nether and we'll go look into doing, getting a slime chunk open. Which, even once I've got it open, please let go. Just let go. I hear a ghast and I don't want to play with it. Shut up. Even having cleared out a slime chunk, granting that I kind of know where one is. Approximately, I know. I know close enough to where it is that I can start excavating around it. Damn it. I just decided I wanted something to eat, so I made had a big bag of these, like, crinkle-cut fries. You know, the big puffy ones. Threw those in the fryer thingy, and, that wasn't the problem. The problem was I got this, well, it's not a problem. I'm totally in favor of it, but I got this, what is it? It's, nuts. It's, whoa, I looked away from the screen for a sec. That was dumb. It is Wishbone Ranch dressing, but this Chipotle stuff. I'm nuts. Don't care. Damn it. He's gonna shoot at me. He really is, isn't he? Oh, maybe not. Okay, well, then you're lost. It's like spicy enough, it'd be really weird on a literal salad. But on fries, it's actually pretty good. It's also really full of vinegar, and that just really wrecks my vocal cords. I don't know why. I already took a bunch of Gaviscon. It's just not entirely helpful. Anyway. Oh, yeah. Slime chunk. You know what? Give me... an idea where I put that. Yeah. Probably no good reason to use that thing, though. Even if it does grow back. Yeah, last episode I mentioned I got this wrong in the episode before that. I knocked it out, like, right here, I guess, and that kept this circuiting, and that is really a neat idea. In fact, I'm just going to do that real quick, too, so I don't need this torch here anymore. Oh, damn. Well, okay. But then if I just kill this, that'll continue to work, and then I can throw this on the ground instead of the torch, which kind of zero-sum, I mean. A redstone torch is just redstone plus a stick, so it's not all that impressive a tree, but, I'm gonna go drop off those doors at least. I forgot. I just had that open too. Scares me. Coming through. Those go there. The rest of this, I'll be okay. I'm going to be amassing a lot of cobblestone and stuff down here, but I should have those crates still against the wall. So, that'll be okay. The slime chunk here is kind of, sort of, somewhere. Do I have any sticks? 20. That's cool. It seems like it's... I don't know where the hell it is. It's in this area. And then over the next, like, 10 meters that way. So it's kind of right in the middle of this corridor I've built. So without being sure, I think I'm just going to take out the whole damn thing. It's just going to be easier. Which, thinking about it, I'm probably about to hit jump cut territory, because I don't only have 51 torches to tie some. Well, again, sticks. It's all going to be weird. If I just kind of... trying to think of anywhere has monsters that can come at me. I think they're all sealed off. What's this about? I know what that is. And this is lit up well enough, I guess we're safe. By the way, is that torch where it belongs, or I just set it down? It looks like it is. Okay. We'll probably be seeing that again soon enough. So yeah, my plan here is just to kind of amazingly, boringly go through. Optionally, I can kind of turn to the right and clear this out and just get a whole grid, which is ultimately what I'm going to do, and then I can just come back and get these 32, well, 31, because one was missing. Or was it? Wait. Yeah, maybe. Maybe not. So this is one way to do it. Probably not going to bother with just these two, these 10 meters. I'll probably, just go, all the way down and, and then just erode the thing in a kind of an oval coming back, a rectangle. Yeah, that could happen. Weird. I really want to be using at least iron here, though, because, a stone pickaxe lasts for not a lot of time. Partly because I'm likely to run into redstones and things that I can't go through with a stone pickaxe, so, like right there. In fact, at that point, I might switch over to the diamond one that still needs to be filled up a bit. But just a bit, we're okay. Alright, so I'll cut this here and come back when I've... I don't know. At some point. Hang on. So, bang. Oh, it doesn't bang anymore, does it? I thought about this, and I changed my mind. I'm gonna go ahead and use this and just gamble. Because it's got... it's unbreaking 3, so it's going to take a little while to get worn out. And then every time I hit something, it's, that feeds back. It's also faster. If I get feedback on experience, it should reap. I should be safe-ish. And of course, it's got Fortune 2, I think. Which means that, for better or worse, I'm picking up more than average on... loose stuff like this redstone. And of course I've got 18 sticks on me and I need pretty much 16 to, how much? Yeah, 22. To replenish my torches, assuming I run out. I brought a lot of stuff down here I shouldn't have, I had a trap door on me and a couple of black carpets. About that, I was thinking I could put carpet on one of the hoppers so that the hatchlings wouldn't sink into it, but then of course if there's a carpet, then the piston pushes against the carpet. It's a big mess. So I just threw out a trapdoor and some carpet here that I can replenish later. It's not a problem. I mean, neither is cobblestone or anything. That's easy to come by, so if I don't get all of this, it won't hurt me. Oops. Is that right? Yeah. Okay. I'm pretty sure... and it relies on versions having not changed the landscape much. I'm pretty sure there's no lava... this high up, I'm not going to find lava raining down from the ceiling. Water, there's some water in the ceiling, actually, but, right around the middle of this whole thing, where the middle is like 65 by 65, or negative 60, anyway. Maybe lava here, though. Oh, no, I'm just dumb. Well, that was simple, wasn't it? I decided there's way lava here, though. I could probably leave that in place. It's cool. So, let's see. Including this. I'm going to see what I can drop off that I don't need. Don't really need that on me, that's for sure. Or this. Stuff I want to keep, but not here. I don't care right now. I could probably do something like this. I'm not going to need that. I'm going to need one of those. There may very well be gravel or something that I'm going to want to do it with a shovel. Yeah, and I don't need seeds on them like that. Okay. So, where are we on? See, it's not that bad. It's not great. It's definitely going down, but I just switched over to it, so. You know, let me just do this real quick. Just because it's bugging me that I can't see what I'm doing with this here. Actually, I don't need any more torches, so that's easy. Okay, well, whatever. Anyway, I'm just gonna run along. This is arguably a little dangerous. It's lit up well enough, I'm not that concerned, but what I'm doing here, there aren't a lot of real monsters that could spawn. It's only 1 meter wide, so unless it was a cave spider, it might be able to spawn. And it's only a meter tall, so I think the worst thing that could happen would be getting a hatchling zombie. Which, those things are tenacious, but I don't care. I can kick them pretty hard. So, overall, it's probably safe enough to do this. And not have anything bad happen. I guess conceivably, I don't know, can a slime, like a really teeny one, spawn in a meter high, or does it need two? I've never seen one spawn in anything this tight, but I guess it's possible, maybe? I don't know. I wouldn't be shocked. But, I do know they can spawn in 2 meters, that's the whole point here. So, at some point we'll have this cleared out enough that they can start. They could actually spawn right now, I think. I think at least in the other corridor to the right, they could absolutely spawn. If they can do it in one by one. You know, one cube, really. But I'm not sure about that. They might need a 2x2x2, room. If you want to call it that. Oh, and again, I'm going fairly quickly because I'm confident there's no lava anywhere under. I'm not going to run and fall into it. Besides, I'm hitting this stuff quickly enough with this thing that I would see the lava before I jumped into it. It's not like I'm right up against it, hacking away with a stone pickaxe. Guardian's bothering me. Alright, this is still gonna go on for a while and be less than fascinating, so I'll come back when I, have a little more done here. It just occurred to me to mention the way I'm doing this now, this is 2x2, or at least 2 wide, so I suppose spiders could spawn, but I don't think they will. I think it's too bright for them, even up there on that, so. That, by the way, is 14, yeah. Even if I wind up, down on the pickaxe when I'm done here, there's stuff in the ceiling I can just pull down and it'll give me lots of experience to rebuild the thing, so I'm not too concerned. Alright, be back in a sec. Okay, good news and bad news. Diamonds. Which is great, except I've got Fortune 2, And now I'm trying to remember why I have Fortune 2. Was that, did it come with the thing? Can I go up and get Fortune 3 real quick? Or, you know, another pickaxe and then smack it onto this to make Fortune 3? Is that an option for me? I'm kind of tempted to find out. Otherwise, you know, this is actually holding up pretty well. 13. Nothing I can't rebuild, just wandering through the nether and hitting quartz. Or even just, you know, thumping chickens or something with it, I suppose. Yeah, I kind of... There's nothing wrong. I mean, I got diamonds the first few days. Once I had a steel iron pickaxe. But I got one from each block. Here I might get two. If I can get Fortune 3, I can get like four. Three or four, easily. And there's a lot of diamonds. In fact, I think... That was a little surprising. I don't remember that being there. I think that's a slight version shift thing. Oh, it's probably nighttime. Let me go up and see what I can find real quick. Is it night? Yeah, it might be. Well, it's all lit up though. As long as there's no zombies inside my village, I'm not too concerned. No, because I turned off clouds, so that is not dark enough to be truly nighttime. I'm not sure. Yeah, it's pretty close, though. Yeah, almost nighttime. Okay, look out. Sleep before anything weird happens. And then we'll go in and... do I have any emeralds around here? Oh, yeah, I should have, because I killed a bunch of chickens. Hang on. Just in case I don't find what I'm looking for from a... Oh yeah, tool guy is going to be tricky. What do you have? You didn't have Fortune, did you? Infinity. So, well, yeah, I like you. You're cool. You are a cartographer. Alright, so I'm looking for... Well, I'm looking for the guy... No. It's weird how long ago that seems now. Nope. Oh, no, he was, yeah, he'd be locked up somewhere because he was one of the first guys, right? I don't know where the hell he is. Fortune 1. Okay, that's a bit of a trick. What I need to do here is get two of them, I guess. Which, on the bright side, is not difficult. Give back. Okay. So what I need to do now... Fortune 3 is as good as it ever gets, right? I'm sure it is. I've never seen... I don't remember ever seeing Fortune 4. It's possible that it exists, but I don't care. Mix these two should get Fortune 2. Leaving me 11, which is concerning. Well, that's not a shock. Ugh, 34. Damn it. Where am I going to get 34? I gotta talk to someone. How does this work? Oh, nuts! Never mind, that's not even you. I need it. It's clerics who have that experience. Boom. Damn. Where am I gonna get it? I could just go into the nether and get it, I guess. Did I say that was 34, or is that something else I'm looking at? Yep. Damn, that's a lot. I could go fishing for a long time, but I don't know how quickly I would get anything. Yeah, whatever. Okay, I'm just gonna go find a way to get 34 and I'll come back when I've got her. Okay, never mind. Hang on. I got my pickaxe all built up again and really only made it to whatever I'm at, I think 15. Which is not enough to... Wait, yeah, 15. So, let's think about that later. I'll just go grab whatever I've got, or whatever I can get, I guess. And, actually, that being the only thing left to get, there might actually be slimes down here. Except I was just in the nether, which may not have given him enough time to spawn. I'm not seeing one. But yeah, they should be in this neighborhood. Oh, give me a... I don't care too much. That's good. Why not? Let's see what we'll get with Fortune 2. Could leave these. Nah, the hell with it. I'll just do this. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Equals 13. Which isn't bad. You know, it could have technically been twice that or so with Fortune 3, but you can't have everything. 4, 8. What did I say the first was? 6? So, let's just call it 14. Is 21. Nope. Is 22. I thought there was another... I thought I saw diamonds in one final place. I don't know where I saw them. Huh, maybe I saw the same one twice. Anyway, right around here, that's iron. Huh. I don't know. I really thought I saw it. That, right there. 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, that's probably all of it. I get 28. Yeah. That could certainly be worse. Alright, let's go ditch stuff I don't care. Give me whatever of this you can. Uh-huh. Well, nuts. I'm just come back. I gotta come back down anyway to see if there's slimes. I know they're far enough south of where we are that you can stand in the corner or even closer than that and they'll spawn. They're more than 32 blocks south of what am I doing? I don't know. Well, that was stupid. Oh, what am I? That's fine. That's not. Give me all of those. And just do that for now. Oh, probably put the diamonds away. Well, actually, give me. I'm gonna be doing blocks. Because see if there's any slimes. And if not, I don't know, I guess I'll jump cut to when I see them. Oh, wait. I'm not sure what could possibly fall down here at me, but just in case. Zombies, but there's no way they're anywhere that's going to attack, right? And the rest of this is just optional, I guess. Yeah, they should be just kind of right about there. I'm going to wander off and see what I've got for iron. Just because I'm curious that much. And then I guess I'll just back away and just sort of lurk right here and keep an eye out. They should just appear in front of me if they're going to happen. Yeah, I'll come back when I know more. Hang on. Alright, nothing yet, but I went ahead and marked out where it ought to be. Yeah, there's no reason not to go over, I guess. Between these torches at 64 and 48, and from right about here, maybe a little further east, pretty much to this wall, should all be a slime chunk. You know, arguably I could take out the ceiling here. I guess I could take out the redstone at least. Oh, I'm outside the zone now, that's nice. I thought I saw redstone over here. I guess I didn't. But whatever, I'll go back away. This being the closest line, basically 5, 10, 15, 20, 5, 35 is a pretty safe distance. And that almost puts me to here, so if I just hang out by this crate, I should be. I can't. You know, far enough away, but close enough to do something about it. So, I'll come back when I have something. Hang on. Nothing yet, but I looked it up. And apparently, I only need to be 24 blocks away. And in fact, more than 32, they can kind of despawn. So knowing that, and assuming I'm right about this being a slime chunk, I think it is. So now we've got 5... 10, 15, 20, 5. Yeah, I don't want to be over there. Let's just say this is our mark. If I'm behind this line, I should get stuff just right there. Okay, back to waiting on that. Hang on. I can't help thinking that if this were, you know, just a big open flat world, I would have been killed 1,000 times by slimes by now. This should be far enough away. I don't know. I'll go over here, maybe. I also looked up llamas. And apparently you can tame them just by right-clicking, but that doesn't do any good. You have to pull them around on a leash. So that doesn't help me much. Until I get a leash. Just hang back here, I guess. This is really just taking a very long time. Hang on, let me check on something. I know I'm right, but be right back. Alright, this is where I think the slime block is. Slime chunk. Between these torches and between these walls. And that's right where I am. They should be showing up here, and I don't know why they're not. You know, 24 blocks away, 32 is, I don't know, just nothing's working. So, and I checked, and the smaller two types of slimes, which is what I'm kind of looking for, only need a height of 2 meters to spawn, so I couldn't tell you what the problem is. I'll go back to waiting for a sec and see what happens. Got one. And it's a, you know, of the, what I can get, it's the big one, so I'm hoping that something comes out of this that looks like a slime ball. Yay! Finally. Okay. Way over time. Hang on, I'm gonna run upstairs. And nighttime, rain, hang on, sleep. Okay. Where would string be, do you think? I don't know. Oh, probably in... What did I do with the string? I do not have... No, I had lots of string. Is it under stuff? Where the hell is string? Ah, good, finally. That was damn near concerning. Okay. Give me that. Yay. Leap into the nether. Come out the wrong portal. Go grab a llama. Yeah, be right back. It's just always something. Come on. Get up. Where did it go? Where did it go? Okay, don't care. Whatever. I'm out of here. Hang on. And came out the wrong portal. Be right back. Village, beyond which is llamas. So, I'll come back when I am inside of those. Cactus I don't want to hit. Food. So if I am understanding, I just right-click this. Oh, right, okay. Yeah, and then, yeah, it's like a horse. Oh, this may take a sec. How many? Yeah, there's another one, and a third. Where the hell is it? If I can just get this one tamed, I'm just gonna... Yeah, okay. So, cool. Get off, because I can't... Actually, are you the one I just... It doesn't matter. Oh, nuts. Where do I live? Over there, I suppose. Yeah. And you two are following this one? Cool. Alright. I'm ready to get down this mountain alive, which is probably not the most... I assume they'll all follow me down this thing. Yeah, looks like it. In a really goofy way, but... Oh! You okay? How about you guys? Yeah, I don't care very much. Come on. Oh, great. What? Yeah. I don't know if I can go too fast for the ones that I'm not actually leading. I really only led llamas around once. I wasn't that impressed by them, so I didn't do it again. But this time, I guess I'm doing it. Mm-hmm. By the way, I have no practical application for llamas. I don't know why I wanted the... Are you okay? Need some Ritalin or anything? Okay. I guess I'm just gonna... I'll just throw it here. I assume the other two will hang around. And then I guess you can breed these things with, like, hay bales, which I haven't bothered doing before. Did I? Maybe I did once. I don't remember. It seems like I may have, but as long as I don't care very much. Anyway, I got those damn things. Where are we at? Are you guys crushing each other by any chance? Those are new, right? I don't know, maybe they're not. Anyway, got these guys, and I don't have the stopwatch going anymore, so I guess we'll probably get 40-something minutes. Once it hit half an hour, it just became academic. So, I'm gonna go. But we got these, and we got a really slow slime factory of sorts. But, you know. Maybe I can expand on that. Anyway, I'll see you next time. Bye.